Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Monday, March 6th. It will be a very nice March weather day today, but things are going to change dramatically. Our chief meteorologist, Dan Zero, says temperatures will begin to drop as we move through the day, and the majority of the state could see some snow falling tonight, and it may accumulate an inch or two in some areas. Now, South Jersey probably just rain, but Central and North will get a taste of the white stuff tonight. Full forecast details are available on air, online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. The Marine Mammal Stranding Center says a 30-foot humpback whale that washed up at the Jersey shore last week did show signs of being struck by a vessel. A necropsy found bruises on the head, a fractured skull, large cuts likely caused by a propeller. It is at least the 13th whale stranding along the Jersey or New York coastline since December. The whale carcass has been buried at the beach to decompose naturally. Monitoring of wind farms and other wind projects has been stepped up in the wake of these whale deaths, but still, there is no link between wind projects and an increase in whale deaths, according to a number of federal agencies. That includes the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. They say there have been about 25 whale deaths, which is about normal for this time of year, and the majority of them have shown signs of being struck by a ship or other large vessel. Gas prices continue to rise in New Jersey this morning. AAA puts the statewide average now at $3.24 for regular. That's up about a nickel a gallon over the weekend. Oil prices have been increasing over the last week or so, and those increases are now showing up at the pumps. Gas is still a bit cheaper than it was a month ago. A year ago at this time, we were seeing huge daily spikes, and we were paying over $4 a gallon, headed towards a record $5.05 a gallon later in the year. It is a sure sign that spring is springing in the Garden State. It's the repair of potholes. The Department of Transportation is launching today their annual campaign to repair these road craters across the Garden State, although there are fewer of them on the roads than normal. The DOT says a relatively mild winter has resulted in a 40% reduction in the number of potholes. Still, thousands will be repaired statewide. A South Jersey animal rescue has come to the aid of hundreds of birds in Buena Vista Township. They were being kept on a property and bred for fighting. The owners were arrested last January, but the birds, mostly roosters, were under quarantine by the U.S. Department of Agriculture to guard against bird flu. Members of the Funny Farm Animal Rescue were called to the scene over the weekend. They said it was one of the most horrific and overwhelming things they have ever seen. Meanwhile, an 18-year-old Asbury Park man is charged with animal cruelty for brutally torturing his pet cat to death. According to the Monmouth County prosecutor, Bonnie's Makatia first sexually abused the animal to the point of injuring it, then tortured the cat until it died. He was taken into custody on Thursday. Many of you may be debating this right now. Should I rent or should I own? The answers to that question are not always easy to find. We have expanded coverage of this at nj1015.com this morning. Leslie Beck is the owner of Compass Wealth Management in Rutherford. She says there are qualitative aspects to consider, and with more folks working from home, the quality of your surroundings makes a difference. And don't buy into the argument that when you rent, you're just throwing your money away, she says. You're paying monthly for shelter, whether you rent or own. Again, our Dino Flamio goes into greater detail to help you answer the rent or own question at nj1015.com this morning. The Rutgers men's basketball game against Northwestern was delayed as smoke started coming out of the scoreboard. Fans inside Jersey Mike's Arena watched as officials tried to figure out what was causing the problem. They ultimately decided just to turn the scoreboard off, and play got underway again about 7 minutes later. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Monday, March 6th. Have a great day.